You logged into your favorite chatbot, typed your prompt, and the result came. But it was largely disappointing. A common scenario, right? Let me show you a method that once you follow it, you'll start receiving awesome outputs from your chatbot conversations. Stick around to see how. The method is made up of 6 elements that formulate a single mega prompt. To showcase it, I'll be using ChatGPT, as this is the most common chatbot people use, but do not worry, it works fine with any other chatbot. Well, obviously, what all prompts need to contain is the task for the chatbot. Essentially, the task is what you want the chatbot to help you with. So, you must clearly define the job you want it to perform using action verbs. Let's work with an example. This is our prompt that contains the task. It starts with an action verb, so it must be right, yes? Well, no. As you see, ChatGPT's response is quite generalized, akin to information one might find in an encyclopedia. This is where most people press the enter button and expect a solid response. But this isn't enough. Next comes the role you want the chatbot to assume. This is essential, as like humans, chatbots perform better if you give them some context. So you must instruct it to assume a particular role. Think of it as having an expert sitting beside you, ready to assist whenever needed. Let's expand on the previous example. Adding the role made ChatGPT alter its response, eventually becoming more understandable. If I hadn't added the collaborative learning part, the chatbot would probably have steered its response in a different direction. Now, I defined that its responses should consider that I want some kind of collaboration between students. This element is the cornerstone of each prompt. The chatbot's response will be mediocre at best without specifying the audience that will benefit from the generated output. So, you must let the chatbot know who's your audience, as well as some fundamental information about it. Fundamental information can be the people's age, their language level, what skills they lack, or the subject they are taught. Let's build up our example. Adding this element forced ChatGPT to acknowledge that my target audience is adult learners taught ICT. This way, I made it consider specific teaching methodologies, such as incorporating adult learning strategies to please my audience's learning preferences. Are you enjoying this video? Please remember to leave a like and a comment, as it helps a lot with YouTube's algorithm. This element is applicable only for teaching-related tasks. The learning framework, or educational approach if you like, is something instructional designers highlight. Therefore, make sure that you ask the chatbot to apply a specific learning framework to the provided answer. But let's stick to our example. Notice how I asked ChatGPT to explain the assigned task using the problem agitate solution framework, which, by the way, is a lovely approach for engaging adult learners. In any case, selecting the proper approach should be based on your audience and topic. Okay, let's now move on to the 5th element. Asking the chatbot to use a particular voice and style can significantly influence how the generated responses sound. Whether it's a professional, authoritative voice or a friendly conversational one, each option conveys a distinct impression. Just think how differently you express yourself when you are emotional compared to how you sound when you are calm and relaxed. Anyway, let's expand the previous prompt even more. This time, I instructed ChatGPT that its output should be provided in a way that a 5th grader can understand it. Simplicity is always nice, no matter the age of your audience. Note that there are various styles you can ask the chatbot to assume. You can find a complete list of the different styles at the link found in the video's description. Finally, the last element is telling the chatbot what the ideal response should or should not be. To achieve that, I'll tell it what to include and what to avoid when generating its response. In our example, I told the chatbot exactly what to avoid: jargon and acronyms. Well, yes and no. Based on what you want the chatbot to generate, there are times that you may need only a couple of these elements, whereas there are certain situations where you need to include all six of them within the prompt to receive better results. Identifying what to include in a given situation requires practice, as it is essentially a matter of experience. Defining the task is a must-have element. Providing fundamental details about the audience, the role you want the chatbot to assume, and the desired education approach are must-have elements. In contrast, setting the voice and style and providing an example are nice-to-have elements, but less critical ones. Well, I asked this exact question to ChatGPT. So, it responded that although it understands and generates responses based on the context provided in the entire prompt, it is better to place the most critical elements earlier in the prompt. This way, you ensure the LLM fully understands the context and requirements. This method is here to help you craft your own customized and effective prompts. But I get it, prompt engineering can be challenging. So, to help you save time, I have compiled a list of advanced mega prompts for teachers and instructional designers that you can find in the video's description. And if you are looking to save up some time, check out this video I created a while ago about paraphrasing AI-generated content. It works great and will make your content sound unique even though you used a chatbot to craft it. So, that was all. Till the next time, see you!